Hello everyone. Today's lecture is about the market research and survey. We will start today's chapter with defining and understanding of marketing information system, research, and the suppliers of marketing research. Further, by analyzing the steps involved in the marketing research process and market survey in detail. And this session ends with the characteristics for good marketing research and generating new ideas in the concepts of marketing research. In this module, you are going to study about the importance of information, research, and market survey for a marketing manager. In detail, the need for marketing information, the research and its process, the suppliers of market information, the process of conducting market survey, and the essentials of a good research will be discussed. The subject expert is Dr. Prasada Rao Bondada, MBA, PhD, working as an associate professor in the Department of Management Studies of Sri Sivani College of Engineering, Srikakulam, and I am Shivangi Anand. Introduction. Management is a series of decision-making processes and believes that decision-making is the heart of managerial activity in business. So decisions need to be made fast, especially in the current environment, where the most precious and least controllable commodity available to managers is time and timely information. Managers believe that the timely, available, and accurate information will be useful for the following reasons. They are A. Operational excellence, B. New product, services, and business models, C. Customer and supplier relationship, D. Improved decision making, E. Competitive advantage, and F. Day-to-day survival. Such timely information is available only through research. Research is not only restricted to medical and science fields, but it is also an important aspect of any organization, whether big or small. A company consists of people, and it is this team that runs the course of the business. Business's success or failure is based on the decisions taken by these people in the organization. At the same time, most managers also need access to facts and figures about the consumer behavior, organization's performance, marketing environment, financial aspects to continually enhance the business, and the quality of their products. Many organizations like ITC, that is India Tobacco Company Limited, Patanjali and Himalaya have full-fledged research divisions for their each category of business. And other small businesses rely on other suppliers of marketing research. The role of marketing information system, that is MIS. Let us introduce this topic by understanding the concept of marketing information system, that is MIS, and the tools of MIS. We know that the marketing environment is dynamic. It always challenges the marketeers with its dynamism. Hence, there is a great need for marketing information, and the same will be possible only through the market research and market surveys. The need for market information is greater than at any time in the past. Philip Kotler has identified the need for marketing information, especially in the following ways. First, it may be from local to national to global marketing. As companies are expanding their geographical market coverage, their managers need to know more information than their competitors. Second, from customer needs to customer wants. As income increases, buyers become more selective in their selection of goods. to forecast buyers' responses to different features, styles, and other attributes, sellers must turn to marketing research. Third, from price-centered to non-price-centered competition. As sellers are increasing their usage of branding, product differentiation, advertising, and sales promotion, they require information on these marketing tools' effectiveness, hence sellers rely on market surveys. So, every firm must organize a rich flow of information to its marketing managers. Competitive companies should study their managers' information needs and design marketing information systems, that is MIS, accordingly. According to Philip Kotler, a marketing information system defined as the system which consists of people, equipment, and procedures to gather, sort, analyze, evaluate, and distribute needed timely and accurate information to marketing decision makers. Hence, the role of the MIS is to assess the manager's information needs, to develop the needed information, and to distribute that information in a timely manner. The information can be developed through internal company records, marketing intelligence activities, marketing research, and marketing decision support analysis. In this session, we discuss only the marketing research and marketing surveys. Meaning of research. Without introducing the concept of research, this current topic will not have any meaning at all. That's why we have to understand and define what research is. Research in general language refers to search for knowledge. Redman and Mori defined research as systematic effort to acquire new knowledge. Some people think research as a movement from known to the unknown. Research can also be a systematic and scientific search for appropriate information on a specific problem or topic. In short, C.R. Kothari defines, it is the quest for knowledge through the objective of finding solutions to a problem in a systematic method. In fact, research is an art of scientific investigation. Let us discuss the important concepts of the present topic in detail. Marketing research system. Like other functional systems of a business, every organization should have a marketing research system to look after the information needs of the managers. It may be internal or external, it is the system in which marketing managers conduct their own research or often hire formal studies on marketing specific problems and opportunities. They may request a market survey on a sales forecast by area, consumer behavior, attitude towards their brand or product preference test, or an evaluation of advertising effectiveness. Suppliers of marketing research. A company can obtain marketing research in a number of ways. Most large companies have their own marketing research departments, for example, ITC, India Tobacco Company Limited, with a diversified portfolio of businesses spanning fast-moving consumer goods, paper and packaging, hotels, agribusiness, and information technology. ITC assigns marketing researchers to each product operating division to conduct research for existing brands. Many small companies act as checking out rivals that routinely visit their competitors and bring back ideas. Companies normally budget low on marketing research, but a large percentage is spent buying the services of outside firms. According to Philip Kotler, these marketing research firms fall into three categories. They are syndicated service research firms, custom marketing research firms, specialty line marketing research firms. Let us discuss them in detail. Syndicated research service firms. For example, Nielsen India Media Research collect trade and consumer information and they sell the same for a fee. Customized marketing research firms. These are the firms which are hired to carry out specific projects according to the terms of the company and they design the study and report the findings. Specialty line marketing research firms. The best example is the field service firm, which sells field service services to other firms. These firms provide specialized research services. The marketing research process. According to Philip Kotler, an effective marketing research involves the five steps. They are, first, define the problem and research objectives. Second, develop the research plan. Third, collect the information. Fourth, analyze the information. And fifth, present the findings. First, defining the problem and research objectives. The first step of marketing research is defining the problem and research objectives. According to C.R. Kothari, there are two types of research problems. They are those which relate to states of nature and those which relate to relationships between variables. A well-defined problem is half solved, hence at the very beginning, the researcher must find out the problem he wants to study. At first, the problem may be defined in a broad general way, and then the ambiguities, if any, relating to the problems is solved. Then, the possibility of a particular solution has to be measured before a working formulation of the problem. In general, the problems of marketing could be about its marketing mixes. Like product mix decisions, pricing decisions, in promotional mix, the problems could be about advertising effectiveness, use of sales promotions, personal selling and publicity, and the problems of distribution networks. Formulating research problem. Basically, two steps are involved in formulating the research problem, like understanding the problem thoroughly and redefining the same into meaningful terms from an analytical point of view. Management must not define a problem too broadly or too narrowly. Objectives of research. The marketing manager and marketing researcher, after agreeing to define the problems, then they agree on the following specific research objectives. They are, first, what are the main needs that the firm is going to satisfy? Second, what kinds of customers would be the most likely to meet their needs? Third, how many customers are likely to offer the product at given different price levels? Fourth, how many extra customers might choose this product or service? Fifth, how much long-term goodwill this product or service adds to company's image? Sixth, how important is that particular product or service for improving other factors? Not all research projects can be this specific. Some research is exploratory. Its goal is to shed light on the real nature of the problem and to suggest possible solutions or new ideas. Some research is descriptive. It seeks to determine certain outcomes. Second, developing the research plan. The second step of marketing research is to develop the most efficient plan for collecting the needed information. First of all, the marketing manager should know about the cost of the research plan before approving it. Designing a research plan includes decisions on the data sources, research approaches, research instruments, sampling plan, and contact methods. Let us discuss them in detail. Sources of data. The researcher can collect two types of data. They are secondary data and primary data. Every researcher generally starts their investigation by examining secondary data to see whether their problem can be partially or completely solved without collecting costly primary data. Secondary data. Secondary data are data that were collected for another purpose and is already existing somewhere. It provides a starting point for research and offers the advantages of low cost and readily available. The internet, particularly the World Wide Web, is now the greatest warehouse of information. In an extremely short span of time, the web has become a key tool for sales and marketing professionals to access competitive information or conduct industry or customer research. Primary data. When the needed data doesn't exist, or outdated, or incomplete, or unreliable, or inaccurate, the researcher will have to collect primary data. Primary data are data gathered for a specific purpose on a specific research project. Most marketing research projects involve in collection of primary data for some extent. The common procedure is to interview some people individually or groups to get the knowledge of how people feel about the product or services, and then develop a formal research instrument, correct it, and present it in the field. When stored and used properly, the data collected in the field can act as the backbone of next marketing campaigns. A customer database is an organized collection of complete data. It provides the detailed information about individual customers, prospects, or suspects. It can be currently accessible and actionable for marketing purposes such as sales lead generation, sale of a product or service, or customer relationships maintenance. For example, Aadhaar database that are becoming increasingly popular data warehousing and data mining for telecom and other industries, but they are not without risk. Research approaches. After deciding on the type of data to be collected, the researchers generally collect primary data in four ways. They are focus groups, sales forecasting methods, behavioral data, and experiments. Let us discuss them in detail. Focus group research. A focus group is an assembly of 6 to 10 people. They are invited to spend a few hours with a skilled moderator or representative to discuss about a product or service, organization, or other marketing things. For effective focusing, the moderator needs to be objective with a sound knowledge on the issue and skilled in group dynamics. Participants are normally paid a small amount of money for attending. The meeting is usually held in pleasant surroundings and refreshments are served to the respondents. Sales forecasting. Sales forecasting is the projection of customer demand for the goods and services over a period of time. There are a variety of methods available to the firm for forecasting sales or demand of a company. They are first, jury method, second, survey of experts' opinions, third, Delphi method, fourth, Salesforce composite method, fifth, end use method, sixth, market share method, seventh, substitution method, eighth, market test, ninth, analytical and statistical methods, 10th, market survey method. Behavioral data. Customers may leave traces of their purchasing behavior in store scanning data, catalog purchase records, and customer databases. People often report preferences for popular brands, and yet the data show them actually buying other brands. For example, grocery shopping data show that high-income people do not necessarily buy the most expensive brands, contrary to what they might state in interviews, and many low-income people buy some expensive brands. Much can be learned by analyzing this data. Customers' actual purchases reflect preferences and often are more reliable than statements they offer to market researchers. Experimental research. The most scientifically valid research is experimental research. The purpose of experimental research is to confine cause and effect relationship by eliminating competing explanations of the observed findings. To the extent that the design and execution of the experiment eliminate alternative hypotheses that might explain the results, the research and marketing managers can have confidence in the conclusions. Third, collection of the information. Research instruments. Marketing researchers have a choice of two main research instruments in collecting primary data: questionnaires and mechanical devices. Let us discuss about questionnaires in market survey topic in detail. Mechanical instruments. Mechanical devices are occasionally used in marketing research. Galvanometers measure the interest or emotions aroused by exposure to a specific ad or picture. Eye cameras study respondents' eye movements to see where their eyes land first, how long they remain on a given item, and so on. An audiometer is attached to the television sets in participating homes to record when the set is on and to which channel it is tuned. Fourth, analysis of information. The fourth step in the marketing research process is to extract findings from the collected data. The researcher tabulates the data and develops frequency distributions. Qualitative data analysis is a process that seeks to reduce and make sense of vast amounts of information, often from different sources, so that impressions that shed light on a research question can emerge. It is a process where you take descriptive information and offer an explanation or interpretation. The information can consist of interview transcripts, documents, blogs, surveys, pictures, videos, etc. Averages and measures of dispersion are computed for the major variables. The researcher will also apply some advanced statistical techniques and decision models in the hope of discovering additional findings. For analysis purpose, SAP for Big Data and Statistical Package for the Social Sciences, that is SPSS, is the widely using software. It's very easy and quick analyzing software for analyzing data. Fifth, presentation of findings. As the last step, based on the analysis and interpretations, the researcher presents the findings to the relevant parties. The researcher should present major findings that are relevant to the major marketing decisions facing management, and the same, if published, will be used as secondary data for some other researchers. Market survey definition. In fact, the market survey is one of the techniques being used in the market research. Market survey can be defined as it is a sales forecasting method, which is used to gather market information that cannot be collected from the secondary data in companies' internal records or the external published sources of data. Cambridge Dictionary of English defines a market survey as an examination of what people want to buy, how to communicate with them through advertising, what competitors are doing, etc. Laurie Warwick described market survey as any study that gathers information directly from consumers by asking those questions about their preferences, habits, and experiences. Types of market surveys. Surveys are best suited for descriptive research. The main advantage of the market survey is collecting the original or primary data to the specific problems concerned. The problems of marketing are different to different firms. Scott Smith has identified the following general types of market surveys. They are advertising media and message effectiveness surveys, advertising value identification and analysis surveys, brand equity surveys, competitive product and market positioning surveys, customers' attitude and expectation surveys, customer intention purchase analysis surveys, customer service representative, that is CSR surveys, customer service surveys, customer trust, loyalty and retention analysis surveys, habits and user surveys, market description services, market profiling segmentation surveys, new product acceptance and demand surveys, that is co-joint analysis, new product concept analysis service, prices setting surveys and elasticity of demand analysis, product fulfillment surveys, sales force effectiveness surveys, sales forecasting and market tracking surveys, and sales lead generation surveys. Tools of market survey. In the market surveys, the primary data can be collected by using any one or more of the following tools. They are questionnaires, telephonic survey, and through schedules. Let us discuss them in detail. First, questionnaires. A questionnaire consists of a set of questions presented to respondents for their answers. Because of its flexibility, the questionnaire is by far the most common instrument used to collect primary data. Questionnaires need to be carefully developed and tested before they are administered on a large scale. In preparing a questionnaire, the professional marketing researcher carefully chooses the questions and their form, wording, and sequence. The form of the question asked can influence the response. By mailing questionnaires. When the researcher and the respondents do not come in contact with each other, as in telephonic survey or personal survey, then the questionnaires are mailed to the respondents' addresses and request them to return after completing the same. The mailing of questionnaire may be direct mail or fax or email. Direct mail questionnaire. If you want to serve a wider audience, direct mail can be used. The surveys can be as simple as a postcard or as elaborate as a cover letter, questionnaire, and reply envelope. Keep questionnaires to a maximum of one page and ask no more than 20 questions. Ideally, direct mail surveys should be simple, structured with yes or no, or agree or disagree. Check off boxes so respondents can answer quickly and easily. If possible, only ask for one or two right in answers. Fax or email questionnaire. Many of the researchers use direct mail interviews also apply to these email surveys. Never send an unsolicited fax that is more than one page. Give clear instructions on how to respond and be appreciative in advance for the data you get back. Types of questions. There are two types of questions asked in a questionnaire. They are closed-ended and open-ended. Closed-end questions specify all the possible answers. Open-end questions allow respondents to answer in their own words. Closed-end questions provide answers that are easier to interpret and tabulate. Open-end questions often reveal more because they do not constrain respondents' answers. Open-end questions are especially useful in exploratory research. Design of questionnaires. Finally, the questionnaire designer should exercise care in the wording and sequencing of questions. The questionnaire should use simple, direct, unbiased wording and should be pretested with a sample of respondents before it is used. The lead question should attempt to create interest. Difficult or personal questions should be asked toward the end so that respondents do not become defensive early. Finally, the question should flow in a logical order. Second, telephonic survey. When the survey is to be fulfilled in a very limited time, the respondents are contacted through telephone. This method is not a very frequently used method, but it plays an important role in surveying industrial respondents of developed regions. Through schedules. Under this method, the enumerators are appointed and given training. They're provided with schedules containing relevant questions. These enumerators go to respondents with these schedules. Data are collected by filling up the schedules by enumerators on the basis of replies given by respondents. Sampling plan. After deciding on the research approach and instruments, the marketing researcher must design a sampling plan. This plan calls for three decisions. They are sampling unit, sample size, and sampling procedure. Let me tell you in detail. Sampling unit. It answers who is to be surveyed. The marketing researcher must define the target population that will be sampled. Once the sampling unit is determined, a sampling frame must be developed so that everyone in the target population has an equal or known chance of being sampled. Sample size. It answers how many people should be surveyed. Large samples give more reliable results than small samples. However, it is not necessary to sample the entire target population or even a significant portion to achieve reliable results. Samples of less than 1% of a population can often provide good reliability. Sampling procedure. It answers how should the respondents be chosen. To obtain a representative sample, a probability sample of the population should be drawn. Probability sampling allows the calculation of confidence limits for sampling error. Contact methods. Once the sampling plan has been determined, the marketing researcher must decide how the subject should be contacted through mail, telephone, personal, or online interviews as discussed earlier. Disadvantages of market survey. Besides number of advantages, the surveys will have the following disadvantages. The data collection is generally the most expensive and the most prone to error. The four major problems arise due to market survey are as follows. They are, first, some respondents will not be at home and must be recontacted or replaced. Second, other respondents will refuse to cooperate. Third, still others will give biased or dishonest answers. And fourth, some interviewers will be biased or dishonest. Characteristics of good marketing research. If the marketeer or the researcher wants to get a good marketing research, their research should have the following seven characteristics. They are as follows. First, scientific method. Effective marketing research uses the principle of the scientific method like careful observation, formulation of hypothesis, production, and testing. Second, creativity. At its best, marketing research develops innovative ways to solve problems. Third, multiple methods. Good marketing researchers should keep away from over-reliance on any one method. They also recognize the value of using two or three methods to increase confidence in the results. Fourth, interdependence of good marketing research recognizes that data are interpreted from underlying models that guide the type of information sought. Fifth, value and cost of good marketing researchers show concern for estimating the value of information against its cost. Costs are typically easy to determine, but the value of research is harder to quantify. It depends on the reliability and validity of the findings and management's willingness to accept and act on those findings. Sixth, healthy uncertainty. Good marketing researchers show a healthy uncertainty towards smooth assumptions made by managers about how a market works. They are alert to the problems caused by marketing myths. Seventh, ethical marketing. Good marketing research benefits both the sponsoring company and its customers. The misuse of marketing research can harm or upset consumers. This increasing hatred leads to consumer regard as an attack of their privacy. This is the end of today's session. I hope you liked this session. Have a nice day and thank you. Thank you.